Hi there, I'm Kimberly Edwards from cookingwithkimberly.com, and today I'm going to show you guys how to make a really cool recipe. It's actually really fast. I'm going to do ham wrap, this maple sugar ham wrapped asparagus. Now, we're going to quick fast blanch this asparagus, and then it's not going to take any time on the barbecue because this ham is really thin. It's almost like lunch meat ham, but it is like kicked up. It's delicious. This stuff is from Harvest Barn Country Markets, and that's, you can find them online at harvestbarn.ca. And this stuff is really, really delicious. Now, if you live in Southern Ontario, then you're good to go. There's two Harvest Barn Country Markets here. There's one in St. Catharines, Ontario, and one in Niagara-on-the-Lake, Ontario. One second. So that's where I got this fabulous maple sugar ham and this beautiful fresh asparagus. They're nice stalks, they're of nice thickness, they're not too fat or anything like that. This is gonna be really great. All right, so the first things first. Asparagus comes like this in bunches. You just take off those elastics, all right? And we are gonna wash those in a nice colander under cold water, okay? Okay, so here's my asparagus. With a large sauce pot on my stove, I have this on a high heat. I'm trying to get it to boil. I'm just gonna put some, it's just water in there. I'm just gonna put some sea salt in. It's the Maldon sea salt flakes. A nice bit. I wanna really flavor that asparagus. Okay, now let's prepare the asparagus before this starts boiling. Asparagus has a woody end and this really pretty looking tip, okay? And these guys, the woody end are just too tough to eat. No matter how long you boil them for, by the time this is tender enough, this is all falling apart. So what we typically do is get rid of the woody part. Now, a lot of people cut it, but what I suggest is you just take it and it has a natural breaking point. You just keep bending until it snaps. You got me? Okay, so let's do some more. Want it like this? Just keep bending. It'll snap where it wants to. Got me? Everyone is a little bit different, and it's au naturel. Do it the natural way, all right? So I'm gonna finish these guys off. By that time, my water should be boiling, and I'll be right back. Okay, so now my water is boiling. It's going. I'm gonna turn it down slight bit because, well, actually, no, I'm not. I'm gonna leave this up until it goes in there. You don't want these asparagus. They're very delicate, the tips, and this is the tastiest part to me, the little tips like that. That is so good. But they're the first things to break off and get really, really tender, right? So you don't wanna boil the mess out of them. You don't wanna have like a big rolling boil because it could damage them, right? So we're just gonna have it on a simmer. Right now it's boiling. This is actually gonna bring the boiling temperature down really quickly because they're nice and cold from the fridge. There we go. Now bring it back up to a boil, but then bring it back down to a simmer. We're only going to have this simmer for 3 minutes. C'est ça. Then we're gonna plunge it into some ice water. So let's get our ice water ready. Fill this with ice and a little bit of water, and then you're gonna plunge it in there as soon as they're ready. Ice, ice. Lovely. What the whole point of this ice bath is doing is, what it does is it takes that asparagus and stops it from cooking any further. So you don't want it to get any more mushy than it already is. It's gonna shock them, it's gonna go like that, and they're gonna stop cooking. And that's exactly what you want. A little bit more water, I need. Let's fill this up a little bit. All right, I'm ready for that. Now, on a side note, don't discard your asparagus woody ends because they're great for soups and stews for flavor, and then you fish them out. You're not actually gonna eat them. But I have a bag in my freezer of just asparagus ends so that when I am ready to make a soup, an asparagus soup or a veggie soup or some kind of cool thing, I'm ready to go and I've got all this great flavor. You don't have to throw it all out, okay? Plus it has lots of vitamins and nutrients in it, okay? Back in my freezer. Okay, so I've put the lid on my pot just to make sure that I can bring it up to temperature as quickly as possible. And we are coming to a boil right now. And I'm gonna set my timer for 3 minutes. Now, let's get this ham ready, okay? I don't know how many asparagus spears. I guess we're gonna have to wait until I count my asparagus spears and then we'll get our ham ready. But I can open this up. It smells really delicious and it is really tasty, and you can tell that it's all maple sugary. Who doesn't want to eat maple sugar ham? Like, really? What doesn't pork make tasty nicer? I don't know. Anyway, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 nice big pieces. And the whole premise here is that I'm going to roll the asparagus in these bad boys, right? Roll them all up in there nicely, right? And then we're gonna grill them real quick. Oh, it's gonna be gorgeous. All right, so sit tight. Okay, so here's my timer going off. Now, I am going to scoop these guys out and put them into... Wow, I don't have any tongs for me. Okay. I'm going to scoop them out and put them into this ice water. Make sure you don't burn yourself if you have hot handles, okay? All right, so we're going to plunge it into this ice water as quickly as we can. The nice, that sea salt kept everything nice and green, right? This is also going to help. It's going to stop the cooking process so everything doesn't turn all gross. All right, plunge. And we're going to let them sit there for a couple minutes, okay? You can dump your water or you can keep it and reduce it and use it for stock as well. Or throw those asparagus tips in and do it now and make some asparagus stock. Okay, so my asparagus has cooled down. My ice cubes have almost completely melted. And I'm just going to take these guys out to drain a little bit. Turn off as much of the water as you can. Okay. And then we're going to quickly doctor them up before putting them in this ham. Now, the purpose for this blanching is, if you could put these guys in here in this ham just raw as it was, and it might cook all the way and it might not. You might get some really hard, you know, crunchy asparagus, and that's not really what you want. So you just want to make sure you get it a little bit part way done, and you're good to go. You can make sure that everything's fine and well and dandy, okay? I'm just going to dry them off quickly. Just a little bit, because I'm trying to put some oil on them. Oil and water don't mix. I want to put the oil on there. See how we were very gentle with the boiling of them? And what's happened is now we have these gorgeous tips still intact. Beautiful. Perfect, in fact. That makes me very, very happy. Okay, so I just used like clean paper towels. They can do a number of amazing, wonderful things in your kitchen, okay? All right, so this is what we're going to do. We're going to count our asparagus. So we've got 2, 4. I'll be back in a bit. 6. Okay, I actually had 36 asparagus spears exactly, and I have 6 pieces of this maple sugar ham from Harvest Barn, okay? So do the math. We're putting 6 spears in each of the pieces of ham. Don't fret. It's okay. These are nice and thin, okay? If they're thicker, you know, use your judgment. Use your judgment call. So that's 6 in this instance. That's not a whole bunch. But first, we're going to season them up a little bit. We're going to put a really good olive oil on. Let's put some olive oil. There we go. Just drizzle, drizzle, drizzle. We're going to just toss it before we put them in here. Olive oil. We're going to crack up some cool pepper. How about that? I'm going to use some nice red Kampot pepper. These peppercorns are from Cambodia, and they're red. They've got black ones and red ones and white ones and green ones and things. Anyways, they have a very beautiful flavor. Each one of the colors has a slightly different nuance to it. The dark ones are very spicy. The lighter ones are a little bit lighter, okay? So anyway, I got these at kampot-pepper.asia. It'll be on the bottom of your screen right now. Right? Cool. So I'm just going to crack these bad boys up. That was maybe, I don't know, 8 or 10 peppercorns. All right, and I'm just going to sprinkle on the top of here. Probably not all of that. A little bit less. And I'm also going to use some really good, nice, salt. I'm going to use this cool Persian blue salt just because that's the one I grabbed. These are Drogheria spice grinders, heavy duty stuff. They have salt and pepper and even chili and garlic, but I just want salt today. All right, so now I'm going to toss that with maybe just a little bit of lemon juice. Hold on. I'm going to use just a hint, a tiny, tiny hint of lemon. That's just going to be a little bit tangy. Pick out those pits if they fall in. Hate it when that happens. Darn it all to heck. Okay, now use your hands because they're your best tools and they're going to be dirty anyway because you're going to be rolling them and stuff, okay? Beautiful. Make sure that you get those tips coated with that olive oil because if they don't get coated, they might have a tendency to burn and you don't want to burn the best part. All right, so grab 6 at a time. You're going to roll them inside this ham from the lengthwise, right? As long as you can. You put it on your cutting board. I actually put these pieces of ham back in the fridge for a little bit while I was waiting for my asparagus to cool. Now I'm just letting each end sort of peek out, and I'm rolling them as tightly as I can without ripping this ham, okay? Now to prepare them, make sure that you put the seam side that you just finished with down on the plate so that when you bring them outside, they're just like that. And that's how you're gonna put it on the grill first, that seam side down first, okay? Next. And then you're gonna repeat this with the rest of your asparagus, and I guess you'll see me in a couple minutes when I'm ready and done, okay? Cool. Okay, so I'm almost done. I'm gonna talk to you while I'm finishing the last ones. Now everything in here is cooked. You can eat these asparagus just like this. You can, in fact, roll them up in these pieces of ham and serve them like this at like a shower or something like that. That's a nice piece of meat, and it's cooked. It's beautiful, you know? It's like lunch meat, sort of. So you're good to go. But my whole premise of here is just to get a little bit of smoky goodness from my grill. I don't even know if I'm going to bring you out there. Maybe I will. It's still kind of light out. I might bring you out. But just to get a little bit of smokiness and maybe some nice grill marks. So it's gonna take like 2 seconds on the grill. You don't wanna grill the mess out of it. You don't wanna wreck it either. It's just gonna be real fast. But don't these look really beautiful? You could make a gorgeous tray of these for some kind of dinner party or something. Plus it's nice and cool. You can eat this in the summer and spring and not feel like you're gonna die from heat exhaustion, okay? All right, so I'm gonna wash my hands and I'm gonna preheat my grill, okay? Be right back. Okay, my grill is preheated, it's outside. I'm not bringing you out there. I'm just gonna tell you what I'm doing. I've preheated it on high, and now I have put some olive oil on the grates as well, just to make sure things don't stick too much on this ham. I don't wanna wreck this ham, it's very thin and delicate. So we wanna keep that all together. So I've already greased up the grates, and I'm about to take it out there. I'm also gonna grill up some corn while I'm out there, why not? These are gonna be done way before this. That's okay, we're not eating yet. This is actually gonna be served kind of cold. It doesn't even have to be heated up, like I said. So I'm gonna go out there and I'm gonna grill it like 2 minutes on each side on high. I want it done fast. I don't even want it sitting there lingering. It doesn't need to. It just needs to get that, the lines on it and to smell and taste good, right? That's it. These guys are gonna be on for a little bit longer, so you'll see me in a little while. Alrighty, all right, everybody, I've just come in from the grill. Now this took, I don't know, like maybe 4 minutes aside, and I just wanted to make sure that I got a nice grill mark. Now you could even go further than that, but I wanted to be very gentle with them. Now these look and smell amazing. Mom, these are the maple sugar ham wrapped grilled asparagus. Would you like to try this?
Oh, I love it.
Well, come on, it's Mama's taste testing. Here we go.
Sounds wonderful, man.
Let's grab you this here. Now this,
isn't that beautiful?
Don't they look pretty? Here, I'm gonna show you one. There, doesn't that look gorgeous?
Oh, it's beautiful.
Maple sugar ham stuffed, maple sugar wrapped grilled asparagus.
Wow.
Good stuff. Try that one. Let's do it. Now that's that maple sugar ham from Harvest Farm that I got. And the asparagus that I got.
Mm-mm.
Is that a good one?
Mm-mm.
Yeah? Am I gonna steal a little bit off your end?
Of course.
Okay. It's good? It's worthy?
Isn't that wonderful? Mm. Oh, that salt from the ham. It just hits that asparagus and just melts in your mouth.
Well, I did use a Persian blue salt today as well
on
it. Where did I put it? Here it is. And it actually has flecks of blue in it, but it does have a very distinct flavor as well.
Mm.
But that maple sugar ham definitely has some really nice salt and
the
sugar.
The sweetness of the ham and the salt, that asparagus with it, what a great pairing.
Now, you can eat this cold for spring and summer.
I guess you could.
Or you can eat it hot right off the grill. But
just throw some in the refrigerator and pick one up for a snack.
Uh-huh. It's like kind of like a ham wrap.
Even you could cut them in half or three for little hors d'oeuvres.
Sushi looking things.
Yes, for little hors d'oeuvres for guests.
I was going to say for showers and things like that. That would even be nice for showers for ladies to pick up instead of
absolutely
maybe a whole piece
beautiful
of quiche or something that's traditionally hot, way higher in calories, right? This is ham, but it's extra lean. And the asparagus didn't. What I did was I blanched the asparagus first, and then I just threw it on the grill for a little bit.
Yeah.
Rolled them
and
up.
You can handle it quite well.
I know. And aren't they bright green from the blanching? Anyhow,
so
shout out to dogbreedcartoon.com. I love miniature schnauzers, and you've seen our little guys booting around here every now and again and growling and barking, etc. in the background. But yeah, so thank you for thatdogbreedcartoon.com. Go check them out. They have every single dog breed you can imagine. They've got the maiden flags and different colors and rainbows and...
That's so cute.
So any little animal that you're in love with that's a dog, you can go get a shirt for someone else.
Dog or a cat or...
Well, they only have dogs. Oh, they dog breed cats. Cartoon. Oh. But aren't they cute?
Beautiful.
It's perfect for me, right?
Beautiful. Is there a dog that you don't love? There
true
aren't.
Story.
We just love all kinds of dogs.
True story. Anyhow, I heart schnauzers, so there you go. And shout out to Sue Enrich at Harvest Barn. Thank you very
Sue.
Much. This is inspired by them anyway. I saw it. I was like, ooh, I'd like to use that ham to wrap those. And she's like, do it. Go do it and show the world, baby. So that's what we're doing. That's how you do it. That's how you make maple sugar ham wrapped grilled asparagus. Gorgeous.
Sue, this is so good.
So good. Gorgeous. Anyway, make sure you check out Mom's website. This is my mom, Ingrid Turner. She's at ingridturnertoday.com. And I don't know, that's it, that's all, I guess, huh?
Mm-hmm. Another winner, my mom.
Yes, ma'am. Winner, winner, ham dinner.
Yes.
Follow me on Twitter at Cooking with Kim E with a capital E. I hope you like the fan page. It's facebook.com/cookingwithkimberly. My shows are on youtube.com/cookingwithkimberly and ifood.tv/cookingwithkimberly. And my site is cookingwithkimberly.com. Come interact with us. Let us know what's going down in your culinary world. All right, everybody? Be champions in your kitchen and eat deliciously.
Bye-bye.